Welcome to the Eye of Truth. The Mahabharata is an ancient Indian epic and is considered to be one of the world's three great epic poems. One passage is of particular interest to today's video. There is something without substance in the universe, in which all events are recorded. It contains all of the information and knowledge in the universe. This passage is referring to what is called the Akashic Records. Akashic is derived from Akasha, which is a word from Sanskrit, an ancient language of India, that means space, sky, or ether. The Akashic Records are said to be omniscient or all-knowing, and the concept or existence of omniscience exists in the beliefs and religions of people all over the world. Some examples include Alaya Vijnana from Buddhism and the omniscient Eye of Horus in Egyptian mythology. Although it takes different forms, the concept is similar to that of the Akashic Records, a state of knowing all in the universe. To the ancient peoples of the world, this could only have been interpreted as the power of God. However, if we consider what the Akashic Records might be from a modern perspective, we can come up with a revised definition. There is a medium containing all of the information in the universe that, if accessed, could provide any information or knowledge you might want to know. Is this interpretation viable? Is there any scientific basis for the Akashic Records existing? Can we gain access to the Akashic Records? In this video, I analyze these questions while taking a deep dive into the Akashic Records. Let's start with my conclusion. I strongly believe that we can already access the Akashic Records. If we look back on history, we find that several people seem to have already accomplished this. I'll cover two in this video. The first was Srinava Iyengar Ramanujan, a genius mathematician born in India in 1887. Born into a poor family, Ramanujan received hardly any formal education in mathematics and had no concept of formal proofs, a crucial aspect of mathematics. Even so, he was able to create many mathematical formulas over several years through passion and effort alone. However, mathematicians of the day were unable to prove whether his formulas were correct, and so he was not well recognized at the time. In order to gain recognition and have his formulas proven correct, Ramanujan sent a letter to G.H. Hardy, one of the major mathematicians of that time, and a professor at Cambridge University, England. Ramanujan began his letter with a brief introduction on the first page, and then went on to write 120 formulas over the next 10 pages. Hardy began reading the letter with some skepticism, but was soon blown away by what he read. Some formulas recreated some of Hardy's own unpublished research results, while others were so advanced that Hardy couldn't even determine whether they were correct. Convinced that the man who wrote the letter must be an unparalleled genius, Hardy invited Ramanujan to England. When the two men first met, Hardy realized immediately that Ramanujan was fundamentally different from the typical mathematician. Most notably, Ramanujan was unable to prove his own formulas. Hardy asked how he discovered the formulas. Ramanujan simply replied that they were revealed to him while sleeping by a Hindu goddess called Namagiri Thayar. Although suspicious at first, Hardy soon became convinced of Ramanujan's incredible abilities, stating the following: "We research mathematics. Ramanujan creates mathematics." This is one of the formulas Ramanujan wrote while at Cambridge University. Hardy and other contemporary mathematicians were unable to understand what this formula meant. However, 100 years later in 2012, physicists researching black holes discovered through sheer coincidence that they were able to use this Ramanujan formula to perfectly reproduce a behavior they had observed in black holes. This story was even picked up by the news media at the time. Why was Ramanujan able to write a formula describing a behavior of black holes 100 years before we even knew that black holes exist? Where did he gain the mysterious ability to create this formula? I believe there is only one plausible explanation. Ramanujan had access to the Akashic Records. Another individual who may have had access to the Akashic Records was Nikola Tesla. Tesla is now well known all over the world for inventing AC generation and transmission systems. Perhaps more importantly, the theoretical foundation for 80% of the electrical technology we use today is based on ideas first proposed by Tesla. You may have heard the rumor that the oil industry and other agents worked together to bury some of Tesla's revolutionary inventions, including worldwide power transmission systems and devices that provided free energy. More importantly for this video, Tesla had a characteristic method of gaining knowledge and producing results that was very similar to that of Ramanujan. When building a complicated system or machine, Tesla always skipped the design phase and would just begin prototyping or building. When asked why, Tesla responded that he had already envisioned the configuration or structure of the system in his mind, and that completing the system was simply a matter of reproducing that vision. Tesla once said something particularly profound: "My brain is only a receiver. In the universe, there is a core from which we obtain knowledge, strength, and inspiration. I have not penetrated into the secrets of this core, but I know that it exists." Tesla seems here to be describing the Akashic records themselves. Is there any scientific basis for the Akashic records existing? Let's take a look. I'll start by discussing physics, which may not seem to have any connection with the Akashic records. Stay with me till the end, though, because this gets very interesting. Physically speaking, a substance contains various types of information. For example, different substances will have different types and arrangements of atoms. A diamond is composed of carbon atoms arranged tetrahedrally, while the lead used in a mechanical pencil is composed of carbon atoms arranged in layers. The type and arrangement of atoms is therefore a type of information. The letters written in a book are also a type of information, and this letter information is basically determined by the type and arrangement of atoms. A substance therefore contains all of the information of which it is composed. According to the research of a physicist named Gerard de Hooft, a substance swallowed by a black hole would be broken down at the subatomic level, and the information contained within that substance would be projected, or encoded, on the two-dimensional surface of the black hole, or its event horizon. The method used to project or encode this information is very similar to a technique for projecting a three-dimensional image on a two-dimensional photograph called holography. And so when this phenomenon occurs in black holes, it is called the holographic principle. Although a substance swallowed by a black hole would itself be broken down, an individual with the proper technology watching this from outside the black hole should be able to reconstruct the entire substance, as all of its information is encoded on the two-dimensional surface of the black hole. The universe is subject to the same physical laws as black holes, so information must be projected similarly throughout the universe. In other words, the information contained in you and me, and in everyone and everything in the universe, is projected on a two-dimensional plane called the cosmological horizon. This cosmological horizon is a medium containing all information, and this plane itself is the Akashic records. Where is this cosmological horizon located? Like with the surface of a black hole, it would be the surface covering the entire universe, and would be located at a nearly infinite distance away from us theoretically. So, how did Ramanujan and Tesla gain access to information from the cosmological horizon? What follows is my personal opinion, devoid of any scientific basis. You may have heard of a part of the brain called the pineal gland. According to research in evolutionary biology, pineal gland cells are very similar to the photoreceptor cells in our eyes, and have the same origin as our retinal cells. It's thought that our pineal glands are the atrophied forms of major organs that were present in the brains of our ancestors. Many mythologies and religions have legends about third eyes, and this concept represents the original form of our pineal glands. The pineal gland was originally used to read information from the Akashic records. Upon accessing the Akashic records with one's pineal gland, information is converted into optical signals, which are then projected on photoreceptor cells in the pineal gland. This creates an image in the mind, allowing for information to be read. I already mentioned that Tesla skipped the design stage when building a device, because he had already envisioned the completed device in his mind. What's more, the eye was used in Egyptian mythology to represent the concept of omniscience. This suggests that the pineal gland may have been used to access the Akashic records. As I mentioned in my Type 1 through 7 Civilizations video, our level 0.7 civilization may have been created by a Type 4 civilization, or even a more advanced civilization. The functionality of our incomplete pineal glands may have been deliberately stunted when we were created by type 4 life forms. Why? They may have feared they would be unable to control their creation if given the same abilities. Can you access the Akashic records? If so, please leave a comment. Thank you for watching.